shall we say, have a break from the band, you know. But my job is just to share with you a short message from Scripture, because obviously we always have something like that in the club this afternoon. Do you remember 30 years ago this week?
October 17th.
Oh, the band behind us saying they were too young. Do you think they were? Hands up those you think they were. You've got three supporters. Someone at the back who knew where they were 30 years ago. 30 years ago next Sunday, to be precise. Do you know what happened then? It was the great storm. Do you remember where you were when it happened? I think most of us were in our beds, to be precise. Jill, where were you?
I was in Brazzaville, Congo.
You?
Well, I heard about it later.
There's always one wants to show off, isn't there? She was in Brazzaville in the Congo. My goodness me.
I remember the roof coming
off. Oh my goodness, you remember the roof coming off. If I went round here, we'd be all afternoon and you'd all have your own stories, wouldn't it? But I want to tell you where I was, all right? Is that okay? Because I was at a course run for the Salvation Army in London, at one of their colleges there, up on Sydenham Hill. And we went to bed on the night of the 15th, and it was fine. You remember Michael Fish had said, hurricane is not going to be a hurricane. Oh, poor man. Okay. Well, there wasn't a hurricane. He was right. But there was a very, very bad storm. And we woke up in the morning. We were due to go out somewhere around London, the people on the course, and we couldn't go. In fact, we could hardly get out of the actual entrance to the college because, you know, there was a little sort of horseshoe at the front of the college. You went in one side and came out the other. And there was a tree there that they'd been wanting to cut down for years. And the council wouldn't let them. And that night, you guessed it, it came down. And it just about missed the building, fortunately. Closed off one part of the drive, but it just about, well, it caught one of the balustrades, but that was all. And so we woke up and we found this tree right across the drive. So we couldn't go out that day. Do you know, I wrote it down, do you know, yeah, there were 18 people killed because of it, but there were nearly 15 million trees that were blown down there. 15 million! Well, we had our tree in the college, and later on while we were there in that course, somebody had the bright idea, they found a saw, and they cut up one of the branches, and the 20 or so people there who came from all over the world, we all took a slice of the branch back with us. And here we are somewhere in my cases, or my boxes, I still have that slice of the tree that fell down 30 years ago. I don't know where it is, to be honest. You know, you have those boxes that you cart around and you never open from one year to another. But we 24 people, I think it was, we all took a slice of that tree to remind us, not just of the storm, but to remind us that we were special to each other because we were on that course together. It was a very important reminder to us. And I was reminded of that when I was thinking of this because Scripture reminds us that every one of us are important to each other because every one of us are related to each other. Let me share you how St. John writes it in his epistle, his first epistle, when he says this: consider the incredible love that the Father has shown us in allowing us to be called the children of God. Children of God. And that is not just what we are called, but what we are. Isn't that amazing? This explains why the world will no more recognise us than it recognised Christ. Here and now, my dear friends, we are God's children. Isn't that special? Isn't that special? We're related to each other. I'm not sure whether you want to be related to the Bible. But there you go. We're related to each other because we are children of the living God. Let's live like that, shall we? Bless you.